So today I'm gonna show you how to make coconut milk or coconut cream. So I have here my one coconut that I've just broken. If you don't know how to break the coconut and you wanna do it my way or the way I did it, just refer to my video that I just posted, like the last video, and you will learn how to break the coconut. So from this tape, what I'm gonna do is just take the pieces of my coconut. So these are the pieces of the coconut, and what I want to do is, because we want our coconut milk to be whiter, so I'm gonna be peeling off, using this tool, peeling off these brown parts. Okay, it doesn't have much. Okay, these brown parts, because I want our milk, coconut milk, to be whiter. So please, so this is what you do. And please, if you've not subscribed to this YouTube channel, kindly do consider to subscribe to my channel so that you can learn more, and you like this video and you share with your friends and your family. The outer part of our coconut, you can see like both sides are whiter. So I'm gonna just go in and cut this. Just like this. The ratio of coconut with the water, if you want to blend, is always 1:1. And for me, I'm gonna just go in with the water so that it can be easy to blend. But what I do is, like I've not measured, what I do is I just make sure the water is above the coconut so that it can be easy to blend. Because I've just used one coconut, so I'm gonna cover the blender, yeah, just like that, and try to blend. The coconut milk is already blended, so you can see this is the creamy one. You set aside another plate and you look for a cloth. Like I have this piece here, the whiter piece. So I'm going to put this on it, these shavs. I'm going to put these shavs on it like that. And I think I should just do them at once. So I'll set that aside. I take my strainer. We have our coconut milk and we have the shavs that I've just removed. Hope they're called shavs. Like, comment down below. So I'm gonna just squeeze to get like the most out of them, because with the strainer and the spoon, I could not like squeeze everything out. So with this piece of cloth, make sure you use a clean piece of cloth though. So you make sure you just put a lot of energy, you squeeze. Yeah, I'm really squeezing, guys. Ooh. Some people just use their hands, so I don't know which can be easier with you all. You can use your hands to squeeze, or you can use the piece of cloth. Milk. Our first coconut milk is tasty and delicious, but if you want another, you can go another round. So you just return this into the blender. So our first coconut milk is here. Then our shavs or whatever I removed out is into the blender that was in the cloth. So what I do is I want to make this pure, you know, I want just to do it the last round. So I use the cloth, because the cloth is better than the strainer. This strainer has some bigger holes. So what I do is I will just go in and squeeze, or make sure it passes through the cloth so that we can get our pure milk without any bigger particles, you know,
because you want your milk to be so pure. See, not much like the first round. So this one is really pure and it's really like thick. So I'm gonna just set this one aside so that we can go and blend the shavs or whatever was gotten out the second round. So this one is done, guys. This one is done. If you want a thick paste coconut milk, this one is done. It's tasty, it's delicious. You can use it at this step, but let's go and get most out of the shavs. This was what we got our first coconut milk from. So I've just placed them in the blender, back in the blender, kept in some water. So I close my blender. Let's blend this the second time. We have our cloth and our bowl. I'm just gonna wrap it on top here and I'm just gonna just pour everything to save on time because this one is easier and you can see a lot is already out of it. Yes, you just squeeze, just the way I'm doing it. Yeah. Guys, you can see this is our thick coconut milk. Thick coconut milk. It's so thick, so tasty, and so yummy. And this is our second blend of the same. So this one is a little not tasty, but it's not thick, but this is the creamy one. Then this is the second one, and then these are the things that these are the coconut shells now, the ones that we got the milk from. So these ones, they are just untasty. I don't know, you can get coconut flour from it, you can dry them and get coconut flour out of it if there are many, and also you can use it for decorating your cake or whatever you want to do with it. But yeah, for us, we were interested with the coconut milk, coconut cream, so I will put this one aside. So this one is thick compared to this, you can see. Yeah, a little test there. If you want your coconut cream, you can just refrigerate this one, the first creamy coconut milk. You just put in the refrigerator, you let it set, and then it will be thick on top. It will be thick. And then you go with your spoon and you just scoop the thick part. Like, I want to close this video because I will not be able to put this in the refrigerator and to be able to show you. Maybe I'll come back with another video. But that's what you do. You just refrigerate this to get your coconut cream, which is just so thick, to remove the water. So the water will be set down and the thick paste will be on top. And then you just scoop with a spoon and there you will have your coconut cream. But again, if you want to use this for cooking like your beans, your vegetable, just go and use this one direct, plus this one you can also use it. You can just do several things with this coconut milk. It's also healthy. You can use it in your hair, you can use it, I don't know, wherever. So guys, thank you for watching this video. Comment, like, and share. At least I've taught you something. Like, I thought like this, it would be good to share with you guys. So comment, share, like, and practice this and let me know how everything came up, you know, with you guys. So thank you for watching. Bye. Till next time.